Relationship, the mirror. Indeed, relationship is the mirror. In the process of relating, the other becomes a mirror. And when you look into this mirror that we call relationship, you can really see how far you have progressed in going. Why is it so difficult then? Why do people tend to move out of relationships so easily to avoid outright? This needs to be understood. We go on saying that we have progressed. I do not get angry. I am a very loving person. Your saying does not matter. What matters when you are in a relationship or you are relating to someone, the other becomes the mirror. There is an American writer, Simone Weil. She wrote a book, The Intimate Enemy. Husbands and wives, they are intimate enemies. This word, intimate enemy, is very beautiful. They are enemies as well as they are intimate. The progress of inward growth of an individual is determined by the way you interact into the relationship. You have to understand the very nature of relationship. Also, there is a way to relate. We tend to give too much importance to relationships rather to the way of relating. Relating is the outcome of meditation. It is continuous flow. When someone attains to meditation, he learns the art of relating. Relating not only to human beings, instead to sentient and insentient beings. It explores the inner sensitivity to all that comes in contact, whether it is sentient or insentient. A meditative person will handle even the insentient objects with the same lovingness as he can handle the living ones. Just observe. You have worn a particular set of clothes that has given you an elegance, a grace, protection, and everything. You come home, you change that clothes. How do you handle those clothes? Your shoes. I have learned this thing from my father. When he will come, the first thing he will do, he will take off his shoes, socks. Socks needs to be aired a little bit. First thing he will do, he will brush, lightly take the brush and brush out the excess dust from the shoes. I have never seen him taking out his clothes and just leaving it rumpled. If it is dirty, it goes in the waste. Dirty clothes basket, otherwise he will hang it on the hanger. If he has to use the same shirt next day so that it gets aired. How sensitive you are in dealing with those clothes, personal articles, your keys for the car, using the car. When you are angry, you slam the doors of the car. And then you say that I am going for meditation or I am coming for meditation. When meditation begins to happen to you, there comes a different kind of sensitivity. Indeed, relationship becomes the mirror of one's inward growth. Relating is the meditative way of living. How to deal with sentient and insentient things. It happened once a man came to Jinnah to know about meditation. He was asked to reach at a certain time, but he reached somewhat late. Meditation session was begun. He had an umbrella. He darted through the door, flung his shoes, went scattered here and there. He put his umbrella and went to sit down in meditation. The master said, You doubted and you had been violent and open with it. And you have flung your shoes even scattered. The first lesson meditation is that you have to go and apologize to the door and the shoes. When you hear for the first time someone telling you that you have to apologize to the door and shoes, what do you mean by apologizing to the door and shoes? I never apologize to anyone for anything. You mean that I have to apologize to the door? Are you crazy? The master said, if you have to learn to be in my company to be meditative, you have to go and apologize to the door and to the shoes. You look at the places of worship or gathering where they have to take off their shoes, how they handle their shoes. Just be observant, watch it, what happens. Then they are looking for their shoes. In almost all such places, there are special places, shelves, racks where you can place your shoes, but these are not placed properly. We do not want to touch the shoes by hand. Consider that the hands will get dirty. Specifically, if you have to go to a Hindu temple, but you have touched many other things while coming to the place, why can't you take out the shoes, pick up with the hands, and place it in the right place, and then go and wash your hands before entering the place? These are the sensitivities which comes to an individual when meditation. You see people around you claiming to be meditators, but when you look into their lives, there is no bliss overflowing, either through their living or through their words. This is a sad life. Hardly ever you see someone who is emotionally mature. One moment we say something, next moment we say something else. And we contradict our own things, our own words. When you begin to relate or enter into any relationship, there always remains the fear of commitment. It is because of this that all problems arise in life. You find yourself incapable of making decisions. Remember, it is only through decisions that you attain to consciousness. You would observe that you can manipulate a small child, ask him to do this and that, he will listen to you. The moment child attains the age of teens, if you ask him to do something, he says that I have my own mind. He is claiming himself to be grown up, and not only grown up, but as an adult. Meditation gives that grown-upness, that adultness, that maturity when you are to make your own decisions. And as you are capable of taking the decisions on your own, without the support of someone, you are growing into awareness. And that gives you freedom. And freedom is the first criteria for growth in life. Remember, it is only through relationship that you attain to consciousness. And when you take the responsibility of your decisions, you stand by others that you become more and more conscious. In this process, you attain to crystallization. This brings sharpness and maturity as well. In the absence, you remain dull and an infant. When you look around, you will observe people moving from one master to another. Also, people move from one temple to another. This does not mean that these persons are really seekers. It is so because such persons are incapable of making their own decisions. And this is the way to avoid commitment. Something like this happens when you come to human relationships as well. You go on moving from one person to another, and you think that you are really a great lover. This simply indicates that you are not a lover indeed. In fact, you are really avoiding a deep commitment. What really happens with commitment is that there comes deep involvement and also the problems relating to these. In this process, you have to face many problems and also the pain associated with it. So you try to place it. And this you do by not going deep into anyone. There remains a fear that if you go deep, you may not be able to come out of the relationship. Whatever be the nature of relationship, be it worldly or beyond, you never go deeper into it. You want to remain on the surface. On the surface, you see the duality, the superficial. You can stand on the seashore and say that you have seen the ocean. On the surface, you only see the waves. Waves are many. Neither the waves is the ocean, nor the sum total of all the waves is ocean. We say that we have been to the ocean. Waves arise on the surface of the ocean. Waves are multiple and ocean is one. When you go below the surface of the waves, you see the oneness, the ocean. In order to know truth, you have to dive into the womb of the ocean. There lies the treasure. So is the case of an individual. On the surface, myriad waves go on arising as you enter it in the world of objects and beings. So too, on the surface of relationship, you only see the superficial. To discover truth, you have to first dive into yourself, then you have to dive into relationship. Your fear of commitment, problems, hurt, etc. keep you away from going deeper into any relationship and thus discovering the inner treasures. And what are these treasures? Serenity, bliss, ecstasy, harmony and oneness. All this keep you away from going deeper in a relationship is because of ego or nafs. Such an experience is what you call for realization or self-realization. In fact, it is wrong to call it a relationship or experience. But mystics always have difficulty in using the language of words to explain all that cannot be put into the words. What they actually want to communicate is beyond words, and words are incapable to encompass all that is. Because all that is really magnanimous, beyond words, Hindus call this uncreated or sound, or a sound that is never created. If you go deep into any relation, then there is a fear that you may not come back. And if you go deep into somebody, then that person will also go deeper into you. Such a phenomenon is directly proportional. Because if I go really deep into you, this is the way that allows you to go deep into me. It is a deep shame. The fear remains that this can entangle you and will certainly entangle you. It brings pain. So you want to place seed. This you do by meeting on the surface only. And your so-called relationships are superfluous and you remain on the surface floating. When you are floating on the surface of the water, you do not find the joys. You may feel relaxed temporarily. But when you dive, you are going deeper and deeper into the womb of the ocean. The same arises diving into the relationship. Husbands and wives may remain for a long time together, maybe 50, 60 years together. But they say there is too much love. But in reality, it is not love. What actually happens when two people stay together for some time, kind of togetherness happens. And this is very easy to be mistaken for love. Love is the shadow of meditation. Wherever there is meditation, love goes. When meditation is not there, love is not born. Meditation is the light that comes to you and manifests through you in the form of love. When meditation happens, there comes the experience of inner oneness, and as the fragrance of meditation, love springs forth. Such phenomena is rarely seen. What you really see around this meeting of two bodies, neither the souls nor emptiness. There is no two emptiness. If you remove the walls that are separating two rooms, there will be one emptiness. The space within the room was looking different because of the barriers, the division that you have created. The moment those barriers are removed, there remains one space. When all the boundaries are removed, disappears, while you are relating, then there comes a space. What you really see around this meeting of two bodies, neither the souls nor emptiness. Such are hit and run love affairs. You tend to run before love. This is what you see around. People have become so juvenile and childish that they are losing all sense of maturity. People have become so juvenile and childish that they are losing all sense of maturity. By maturity, I do not mean physical maturity. I mean inner or spiritual maturity. Maturity comes only when you are ready to face the pain of your being. Maturity comes when you are ready to face the challenge. And remember, there is no greater challenge than love. Remember, to live happily with another person is the greatest challenge in the world. You can live peacefully alone. It is very easy. However, it is very difficult to live peacefully, joyfully and meditatively with another person. That is why you are asked to enter into the relationship. I remember when I was growing, and when anyone will ask the master to initiate, he will say you have to wait until you get married. Get married first and then you will be initiated. More once, it is very difficult to live peacefully, joyfully and meditatively with another person. More so when someone else is your wife or husband, it becomes almost impossible. What happens then is that now two egos collide, two worlds. It is also the explosion of two differently understood worlds. My room and your room. My room is better than your room. My car is better than yours. But we forget that car is a means of transport to take you from one place to another. How can the two opposite poles meet? How can the two be attracted to one another? They are totally different, almost opposite, polar opposite. Then meeting happens only on the surface, and there is no question of merger of two worlds, two egos. First of all, you have to dissolve and explore your oneness, your inner space that comes through meditation. And then when you enter into relationship, it is a totally different kind of relationship. Therefore, it is difficult to be peaceful and loving in a relationship. Because that is the challenge. And if you escape from that, you escape from maturity. If you go into it with all the pain, agony and all that a relationship brings, and still continue delving deeper and deeper into it, then by and by, pain becomes a blessing. The conflict becomes a synergistic harmony. And then by and by, through the conflict and friction, crystallization happens. Through the struggle, you become more alert and more aware. The other becomes like a mirror to you. You can see your ugliness in the mirror. You can see your ugliness in the other who acts as a mirror. The other provokes your unconsciousness, brings it to the surface. That is the fear that we do not want to go into the relationship. The other, we go on saying, he or she makes me angry. And we feel proud of it, but we don't understand what are we saying. The mirror projects your ugliness, your blemish spots. Do you discard the mirror or say that I will not see the mirror? No, you stand more in front of the mirror because the mirror is projecting your inner ugliness. And then it is through the mirror, when you spot the ugliness of spots, you use makeup and all that is required to remove those. If there are pimples and other spots, you go and get the treatment for that. Why we can't use relationship as a mirror, look into our ugliness and then go and correct it. And when you are aware that, then you continue to grow in maturity. And what happens? And what then happens? No words can encompass the magnanimity of it. It is like a dumb has now tasted the sweet fruit. He cannot describe the taste. Only through silent gestures you can speak of inner happening. Love speaks through silent gestures. You can only come to know the hidden parts of your being through the mirror of relationship. These are to be mirrored, reflected in the relationship. This I call isi, because there is no other way, and it is hard. It is hard and arduous, because you will have to change through it. And when you break the mirror, how can there be the reflection of the hidden parts of you? Your ugliness, your ego, etc. You know what this word etc. means? E-E-C. I have just used the word. Your ugliness, your ego, etc. E-T-C. It means the end of thinking capacity. Cannot think of any other words, so you use etc. This is the lighter side. And when these are not reflected, there is no way to improve or let the inner beauty to manifest. So too, when you come to a master, there comes an even greater challenge before you. Because then you have to decide quickly. The problem is greater because you have to choose the unknown and unknowable. Also, your decision has to be total and absolute. This is not child's play. And once you have made a decision, there is no return. This brings so much conflict. So the easiest way is to go on changing continuously. This is the way to avoid yourself, and you will remain soft, babyish, and maturity will not happen to you. Only the unknown and unknowable should have a call for you, because that you have not yet lived. You have not moved into that territory. Move. Something new will definitely happen, and then your silent gestures. Therefore, always go for the unknown, whatsoever be the outcome, and you will grow continuously. But in all circumstances, you go on choosing the known, and then you move in a continuous circle with the past again and again coming to the surface. You go on repeating it. And in this process, you have become compact disc that is moving in a repeat mode. So think it through and decide. The sooner you can do so, the better. Postponement is really stupid. Tomorrow you will also have to decide. So why not now? And now is the precise moment. And you think that tomorrow you will be wiser than today? Do you think that tomorrow you will be livelier than today? Do you think that tomorrow you will be younger than today or fresher than today? Will tomorrow never come? Firstly, tomorrow never comes. And tomorrow you will be older, you will be less courageous, and also there will be depletion of vanity. But you go on thinking that tomorrow you will be more experienced. Instead of experienced, you will be more cunning. As time moves, you are coming closer to death. The wheel of time is moving, and soon frigid claws of death will descend and seal your coming free. Then you shan't have time to live. And then you will start waving with more fear. Never postpone anything but tomorrow. And who knows, tomorrow may come or may not. If you have to decide, you have to decide right now. Because transformation can only happen in this very moment, now and here. Remember, relationship is a mirror. Keep on polishing your mirror so you can see the true reflection. Remove all the dust just as you have mirror in your restrooms, in your dressing rooms. Everywhere we place mirrors so that we can see our reflections. Cherish relationship as a mirror. Mirror to project your inner ugliness. And unless your ugliness is projected and you become aware of it, there is no way to claim. Relationship is in me.